Welcome back, student. In the previous lecture, we have started our discussion about short-circuited and open-circuited dissipationless transmission line, and then we came to this final conclusion that we can represent this voltage and current for the dissipationless transmission line in terms of cos 2 pi s by lambda and sin 2 pi s by lambda, and we also find the expression for open circuit voltage IOC, open circuit current IOC, and open short circuit voltage and short circuit current till this point. Now, once that is known to us, so next thing that we will try to see is the standing waves and standing wave ratio. What exactly standing wave indicate, and what is the standing wave ratio? Now, see, let's say I am having a certain transmission line which is carrying this signal, a sinusoidal in nature, something like this. So, just try to understand. You are an observer, and this is a load end. Let's say this is a load end. I will just represent this as a load end, and being an observer, you are observing from this particular point, and this wave start traveling in this direction, and at this particular point the load is not matched. What I mean to say is that ZR is not equal to Z0. See, this is very important condition too for a line to be lossless, distortionless. We are discussing about ZR equal to Z0. If ZR is not equal to Z0, that means that there will be definitely either it can be open circuit, either it can be a short circuit, there will be a standing wave pattern. What I mean to say that the incident wave will strike this load and will come back and start traveling towards the source in the reverse direction, and they form a standing wave pattern. Standing wave pattern means the wave neither propagating in any of the direction and stand still. So it is standing at certain direction, and it is himself is not propagating, and he is not allowing other waves to propagate through the medium, and we say that the standing wave pattern is observed and wave propagation has stopped. So this is the pattern of the standing wave, and how these standing waves are created and what we can do for avoiding standing wave. Let's understand. If a voltage magnitudes are measured along the length of the line terminated in a load other than R0, that means if we have a load other than R0, it should be ZR, load impedance is should be equal to characteristic impedance, then wave will appear as shown in figure below. So how this wave appears? Something like this. In case if load is open circuited or short circuited, the wave will appear as shown in below. So if load impedance is not equal to R0, this pattern we are able to observe, and this is having Emax amplitude, Emin amplitude. What we are going to do with this Emax and Emin, that we will see. If it is not matched with R0, but it is short circuited or open circuited, the voltage pattern will be something like this. See, so the voltage, open circuit voltage is maximum, then it has reached here, then this point, then it has come to zero, then once again maxima and minima. So the maximum and minimum values on the line are shown in figure 1, and nodes and antinodes are shown in figure 2. So this figure 1 indicates maximum value of the voltage and minimum value of the voltage when load is not matched. And this another diagram shows the nodes and antinodes, that is a maximum voltage and minimum voltage only when load is either short circuited or open circuited. Nodes are the points of zero voltage and antinodes are the points of maximum voltage or current. Okay, so this is the point of minimum voltage or current, and this is the point of maximum voltage or current. So a line terminated in R0 has no standing waves. So if transmission line is terminated, terminated means if the load impedance is equal to characteristic impedance, so no nodes or loops, and it is called as a smooth line. This is very important to understand. If I want a smooth line, that is a wave propagation should be smooth from source to the destination, the care I should take is that ZR equal to Z0 or ZR equal to R0. The ratio of maximum to the minimum magnitude of the current or voltage on line having standing wave is called standing wave ratio, and we come to this particular conclusion. Standing wave ratio, it is ratio of maximum to minimum. What is that? Maximum voltage or maximum current to maximum minimum voltage and minimum current. So Emax upon Emin is also equal to Imax upon I minimum. So what is this Emax, Eminimum, Imax, I minimum? These are nothing but the maximum voltages and minimum voltages, maximum current and minimum current on the standing wave pattern. The maximum voltage along the line occur at a point at which incident and reflected wave are in phase and add directly. What I mean to say, if incident wave is something like this, and if it is in phase added with the reflected wave, something like this. So if they are both of them are in phase, this voltage will get added and I will get this standing wave or maximum voltage. If they are out of phase, I am getting minimum voltage. So Emax will be observed where transmitted wave and reflected wave, incident wave and reflected wave are in phase, and maximum voltage will be maximum voltage is observed when incident wave and reflected wave are in phase, and if they are out of phase, minimum voltage point is observed. That is the point of node and antinode that we already discussed. So from the voltage equation, can we write something like this? E is equal to ER ZR plus Z0 upon 2ZR e raised to j beta s plus k e raised to minus j beta s. Yes, I can write now. At the point where incident and reflected waves are in phase, if they are in phase, then it comes out to be, what it comes out to be? If they are in phase, E maxima is equal to ER into ZR plus Z0 in, divided by 2ZR, 1 plus mod k, k is a reflection coefficient. Yes or no? And if they are out of phase, since they are in phase, they are added. If they are out of phase, they will be subtracted. So ER into ZR plus Z0 upon 2ZR, 1 minus mod k, at the point incident waves are in out of phase. So this is a condition for out of phase, this is a condition for in phase. So if that is so, so standing wave ratio can be given in terms of reflection coefficient. How we can represent now? E max upon E min. So E max I know, E min I know. If I divide these two equations, the ZR ZR cancel, Z0 Z0 cancel, ER ER cancel, and I am left with 1 plus mod k divided by 1 minus mod k, and this k is nothing but reflection coefficient that we already studied. What is reflection coefficient k? Reflection coefficient k is equal to ZR minus Z0 upon ZR plus Z0. So ZR minus Z0 upon ZR plus Z0 will be a reflection coefficient case, and we need to put it here to calculation of the case. So standing wave ratio, how they are related to the value of k? Value of k and standing wave ratio are related like s equal to 1 plus k upon 1 minus k. This modulus is always taken just to avoid the confusion. Equation number 4 can also be written as k equal to, if I want to write k in terms of s, just multiply this, it will be s minus 1 upon s plus 1. And once again, put the value of s as E max upon E min minus 1, E max upon E min plus 1. So E max minus E min divided by E max plus E min. This is the reflection coefficient equation. Is it okay? Now let's make certain conclusions from this particular thing. Now I know standing wave ratio. What is the standing wave ratio? Standing wave ratio is equal to E max upon E min. This is the first form. Then next form is standing wave ratio is 1 plus mod k upon 1 minus mod k, and k is equal to A max, k equal to s minus 1 upon s plus 1, and k equal to E max minus E min divided by E max plus E min. So what is the range of values for k? A reflection coefficient will range from 0 less than or equal to k less than or equal to 1. This is very important term to understand. So value of k will vary from 0 to 1. The reflection coefficient cannot be more than 1. And if I put value 0 here, so standing wave ratio, let's calculate the range of standing wave ratio. If I put the value minimum value 0, standing wave ratio should be minimum value will be have 1 less than or equal to s standing wave ratio less than or equal to. If I put k equal to 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, so 1 upon 0 is infinity. So range of s will be from 1 to infinity, but range of k will be from 0 to 1. So standing wave ratio will range from 1 to infinity, whereas value of reflection coefficient k should be range from 0 to 1. It is obvious from the fact that reflection coefficient is nothing but the amount of wave which is reflected to the amount of wave incident. Reflected wave cannot be no way, or it is not possible to have a reflected wave more than incident wave. So its ratio will be minimum 0 and its ratio will be maximum 1. So this standing wave ratio will range from 1 to infinity, and reflection coefficient will vary from 0 to 1. So both these forms you should remember: E max upon E min, then S equal to 1 plus mod k upon 1 minus mod k, and k equal to S minus 1 upon S plus 1, and k reflection coefficient in terms of max voltage and minimum voltage can also be written as E max minus E min divided by E max plus E min. So in the next lecture, we will talk about input impedance of the dissipationless line and how these equations can be represented for further investigation of the transmission line. Is it okay? So thank you very much and happy learning.